I want to share with you some of my favorite tools for managing a remote team. And these are absolutely critical for me as a business owner. We've now been operating a remote team for over 6 years now. Our company is 11 or 12 years old now, I think. And we've used a number of technology tools to keep our team connected and to keep our business successful while operating fully remotely. And I want to share with you some of my favorites and some of the ways that we use them and how they replace how we used to do things when we were in an office. Now, in the last year, everyone during the pandemic has had to work from home, but for a lot of people, they just kind of installed Zoom and kept working the same way they have always been working. And some people do tasks on emails, some people do tasks on chat. I've seen some businesses who have like WhatsApp groups with their staff and people are putting voice notes in there, and it's just like the worst productivity I've ever seen. And it just scares the absolute crap out of me. So I want to show you some of the most basic tools that you and other team members inside your business can use to keep productive. So the number one to get right with a remote team is tasks. And for us, we use a tool called Asana, which basically helps us keep everything on the same page with our tasks. And this is, it's so underrated to get tasks correct in a business, because for what most business owners do is, particularly if you're one of the creative types as I am, is you imagine a vision of something that you want to happen, and then you just kind of like share it on a meeting once, and then in your mind, it's already done. It's already created. And you know, you check in on it 3 weeks later when you remember it and it hasn't been done, and you go, shit, why hasn't it been done? And it's because you didn't actually correctly delegate it to someone to get that task done. Now, sometimes for some of us that are a bit more diligent, we might, you know, write it up on a whiteboard, or maybe we'll put it in an email or a chat message. We'll ask someone to do it in writing. And depending on that person's level of diligence with how they do tasks or how they do projects, it may or may not get done. And that all works fine when you've got like a small team, maybe you've got one or two or three people. But the moment that you go to 5, 10, 15, 20 employees and north of that, or if you are a small business and you want to scale your business, you've got to get on top of tasks and you have to have a system for them. Now, I'm not saying that Asana is the perfect system for every single business. What I am saying is it's a great solution if you're just getting started. It happens to be our favorite and we've recommended it to hundreds of businesses that have implemented it. And getting tasks out of your head and into a system is the easiest way to get some sanity in your business. And what I mean by that is having a task system where tasks are actually documented and everyone follows the system, because that's vitally important, it removes the need for you to ask your team, is it done yet? Is it done yet? Is it done yet? Is it done yet? All day long. Basically, you can see whether or not a task is complete. And the best thing about having a task collected in a project is you can do things like a Gantt chart, and you can see different deadlines, and you can see who's responsible for what task. But what I love doing most of all is having our weekly meeting and opening up the task board, and then everyone gets to actually check in on their tasks really simply with done, not done, or in progress. And so having a simple task system means that everyone is going to be on the same page. Now, why would you do this instead of using something like a spreadsheet or a Google Doc? Some of the features of using a task system like Asana are the fact that you can actually put in things like due dates, you can have subtasks, you can set up, you know, one project with particular milestones or deadlines. Some of the amazing paid features have things like custom fields and deep integration with other apps, and you can set up automations and rules that actually go through automatically, all kinds of cool stuff that you can do with a system like Asana. And of course, there's alternatives like teamwork.com and monday.com and Podio and all kinds of different apps and systems that you can use for tasks. But this is our favorite one for you to get started with. If you do one thing, get your tasks right, and you will get your team so much more on the right page. And that's one of the first things to get right in our growth roadmap that we help early stage businesses with. Number two is keeping connected to your team. And I'm gonna go against the grain here. Most people use Zoom for a lot of their work. I'm a big fan of Google Meet. And the reason that I love Google Meet, or one of the reasons that I love Google Meet, is because it runs in the browser and it just works. It doesn't crash. It doesn't have to reload every time you open a room. It's a single app that just works each time, and you don't have to worry about updating to the latest version. If you record a meeting, you don't have to worry about it rendering and slowing down your computer while you then wait for it to upload. Google Meet has a bunch of advantages over Zoom, and if you're interested to learn more about that, then check out our YouTube channel where we have a number of other videos on Google Meet, including a 2021 update with all of the new features like breakout rooms, voting, and all kinds of great new features built into Google Meet that you don't have to reach for Zoom for anymore. Now, when I'm working in my truck, I literally have an iPad Air, and that is my main Google Meet device. I use that for everything, and from there, that basically runs meetings all day long, which is really cool. And then you can see there, I've got my computer that just sits right under it, and my computer is effectively there for me to use as my primary device for actually getting work done. And so I've got one device for working and one device for connecting with my team and actually doing meetings. Next critical tool is Google Chat. And we use this instead of Slack or WhatsApp or Facebook Messenger, as I've seen other business owners use, because of the deep integration with the rest of the Google ecosystem. Basically, this sits right inside of my Gmail. It's got all these cool AI features where it can automatically add responses and things like that in there. I've got bots and add-ons where I can have messages automatically populate inside Google Chat by default from third-party apps. And so when a sale happens inside our CRM, which is Copper CRM, it automatically will post in there. When a customer gives us a thumbs up rating on a support ticket from Hiver, which is our shared mailbox application, that will actually pop up in there and the rest of the team can jump on and give everyone a high five. And so I love Google Chat for everything that it's integrated with. There's also an amazing integration with Google Calendar, which means that you can set up a meeting and it will automatically look at everyone's calendar availability and schedule that meeting for you right from within chat. And so for me, I quite often find that I'm chatting to a colleague back and forward and we want to just like jump on a spontaneous meeting. With one button, I can actually click and add a Google Meet right into the chat there, and it's going to take me straight into a meeting with whoever I'm working with. So that is my number three most critical tool for managing and working with our remote team. Now, if you've caught our previous videos about how we went from office to working remotely with 50 employees, you'd know that we actually try and replicate things that we would do in a physical office in our remote team. And one of those is having a water cooler chat thread, and that all happens inside of Google Chat, where people can goof around, post memes, post videos, post funny things that they find on the internet, and basically have, you know, off the cuff kind of chit chat, and that keeps teams connected. And I love using Google Chat for this because it's a way of feeling like we're in the same place, even though we're all working in different locations. My next recommendation is Google Drive, and specifically the shared drives features of Google Drive. Now, if you've been using Google Drive for a long time and you're still on the basic plan, which is now I think called Starter on Google Workspace, they changed all the names, that old plan doesn't include Google Drive shared drives. And shared drives act a little bit like a company server, which we used to have in the old days when we had local infrastructure and Microsoft servers in our businesses. It allows the company to control the files that actually sit there. If you've used Gmail and Google Drive in your personal consumer Gmail account, maybe you haven't switched to a Google Workspace business account yet, or maybe you're still sharing files out of your own My Drive, those files and folders aren't really safe. If you've created a file, you're the owner of the file, and that's fine for you. But if you're working with someone outside the business, like maybe a contractor or an assistant who's external to your business, and they create a file and pop it into one of the folders that you own inside your My Drive, if they created the file, they own that file, and that means that they can actually delete that file on you. And we've seen horror stories where someone does not own the files in their business because a contractor has created them, and when that contractor leaves the business, those files get deleted and poof, they disappear. And so using Google shared drives inside of Google Drive means that you have corporate control over all of those files, and you'll be able to actually see and manage and choose who has access to those files. So if I go and open up my Google Drive here, I'll show you guys exactly what it looks like inside my own personal Google Drive. I'll open up my shared drives here, and you can see here I've got all the shared drives for itGenius that I have access to, but I also have other shared drives here that are actually owned by other domains. And what this means is if I place one of my files into one of those shared drives, I'm going to lose the ownership. It's going to become owned by the company that controls that shared drive, and therefore that's locked down and safe. The other great thing about Google Drive and using that for all of your storage is how it actually stores files. And so if you've used Dropbox or if you've used Microsoft OneDrive in the past, you'd know that they can get a bit cumbersome, especially when you have lots of files sitting in there because they're all being synchronized down to your computer and it starts to kind of like fill up your hard drive, right? And so with what was called Google Drive File Stream, it's now just called Google Drive for Desktop. Google will actually automatically synchronize only what's needed down to your desktop. So you may have, in this example here, 100 gigabytes of files sitting in the cloud in your total Google Drive of all your company files, and only 1 gigabyte, if that's all you're using, is going to be synchronized down to your local computer. Now, you can always choose to save certain files offline or certain folders offline if you want to access them if you're on a plane or something like that. That totally works, no worries. But the great thing about how Google Drive works is that you don't have to have the whole corporate server downloaded to your computer. It means that you can leave it nice and lean and clean. And to be honest, most of us are doing a lot of our work in Google Docs these days, which all run in the Google Chrome browser anyway. And so that's my pick there of Google Drive. If you're still using Dropbox, if you want to make the switch, have a chat to our team. We've got an amazing program called the Google Drive Blueprint, where we help migrate your data cloud to cloud so you don't have to bother with dragging and dropping it. Okay, let's talk next about one of my other most favorite tools for remote work, and that is doing phone calls. Now, many business owners, unfortunately, still do business using their mobile phone, and I really don't agree with that. For me, my mobile phone is where my mum can call me, where my family can call me, where my close friends can call me, and I don't want my customers texting me at 10 o'clock on a Sunday night because they have poor boundaries, asking me about work things. And so 5 years ago, I removed my mobile phone number from my email signature, and so it's no longer accessible to the public. But I started using an amazing tool, which we now resell, called Dialpad. And what Dialpad is an app that gives you a business phone number that comes with you everywhere you go. And so Dialpad works on the mobile. It also works on your desktop computer as well. And it's a fully fledged business phone system for you and your team, which works across all of your different devices. And we've got plenty of other videos on Dialpad on our YouTube channel. Please go ahead and check those out. The most amazing thing about Dialpad is it doesn't require any servers at all. It's all completely cloud hosted. And you can do cool things like switch calls between your computer and your mobile phone. But the thing I love the most is I can put a business number on my signature, and anytime someone calls that number, it's going to come straight through to my mobile phone, no matter where I am in the world. And so I'm going to see it ring with Dialpad, and then from there, I'll be able to actually answer the call, and the customer has no idea that I'm not in the office. As long as I've got 4G or a decent Wi-Fi connection anywhere in the world, I'm able to access, not only receive, but also make calls from my business line from my mobile. And it's really the best of both worlds. Having the business line, which is professional, it looks better for branding. It's got unlimited calling, so you can call as many people as you like for as long as you like, but you also have the portability of the mobile phone. And I still get to use my mobile for my mobile calls as well. And so if you're interested in that, or you want your whole team to have one phone number to dial out from, so you've got nice consistency in your branding to your customers, then jump on to Dialpad, have a chat to our team. We'll be able to hook you up with some licenses and a test drive of the system to help you out. Speaking of test drives, I like to sum up the Google ecosystem as the Tesla of technology. Everything works seamlessly together and in perfect harmony. And what we see is many business owners have subscription overwhelm and a hodgepodge of different apps and services that they're using to try and get their work done. Now, not only does this get obscenely expensive to use all these different apps, because it's another 10 bucks here, another 10 bucks there, and if you've got 5 or 10 employees, you end up having a subscription for everyone, for Zoom and for Skype and for Slack and for all these different apps. And sometimes you can get data that gets held hostage in there or even lost. I know with Slack, if you go over 10,000 messages, all of a sudden you can't search back to the old ones. And if you need to find something from last year, then you might not be able to find it anymore. I've got other videos on the perils of using Zoom and the perils of using Slack when you're already a Google Workspace customer. But I want to implore you to bring everything into one. Bring everything into the simplicity of a simple system. And that's the simplicity of Google Workspace. A Google Workspace is one collaborated set of apps and services which really allow you to get work done in the googly way. Now, yes, there's not every single button that you'll find in Microsoft Word in Google Docs. There's not every single button that you'll find in Excel inside of Google Sheets. Keynote is not the same as Google Slides. But let me tell you, and I'm using a Google Slides presentation now, it's 90-95% of the way there. And when you consolidate all these apps to a simpler way of working, and you know, remember, we've helped thousands of businesses scale to large organizations, and we've seen which ones are successful and which ones are unsuccessful. The successful ones are the ones that do things simply. Your job is to empower your team to get their work done in the easiest way possible. And so you want to give them tools that are easy for them to use, that are logical for them to use, and that don't get out of control as your business grows. That's my last little nugget that I'm going to leave you guys with. If you have any questions, please drop them right below this video right now, and myself and my team will do our very best to answer them. Thank you so much for joining this presentation. If you have not already investigated our growth roadmap, head along to our YouTube channel where there are playlists for each stage of business that you are at. So whether you're a launch business, a startup business, a growth business, a scale business, or if you're off to the moon in accelerate mode, we have videos designated and designed for each stage of business that you're at. And really the aim here with our growth roadmap is to make sure that you don't miss anything important along the different stages of business growth. When you're a two-person business, you don't need to have business dashboards with KPIs on a TV up on the wall. But if you're a 20-person business and you haven't got password security sorted out with an application like LastPass, then you're going to be in trouble. And so go through our different videos on the growth roadmap and learn what things you need to tick off at the different stages. And of course, if you're interested in some help from our team, we'll be very happy to help out with that as well. Speaking about help from our team, we have an amazing free offer for existing customers of Google Workspace, even if you signed up through a web host or through Google directly, and that is our transfer in offer. Now, we give you access to a Google Classroom with professionally recorded videos all about Google Workspace. And not only do you get access to that, but you also get access to our Remote Work Playbook, which was an 8-video webinar series last year going open book on how we grew and scaled our business into a remote company over the course of 6 years and how we've been able to remain successful doing that. Now, inside that library, included in those videos is a set of quizzes so that you can actually train your team on how to use all the best features of Google Workspace. And those Google Workspace videos are going to help your team become competent on everything to do with the Google world. And so how to get the best out of Gmail, how to get their inbox down to zero each day, how you can structure your Google Drive permissions correctly so you get everything set up and safe and secure so you don't ever lose any data, how someone can get the most out of Google Calendar and share their calendars properly, create team calendars, and get everyone humming along nicely. All of these are included as soon as you transfer in your licenses to itGenius. Now, what does that entail? You don't pay any extra for your Google licenses. You just put your billing through us. We're a wholesaler of Google Workspace, and so we pay Google directly, and we can give you the same price that Google gives you, but we can give you a bunch more goodies. And it doesn't stop you from getting free support from Google if you still want to get access to the Google Help Desk, but you do get some limited free support from our own professional support team and access to a few of our other tools. If you're interested in that, head along on the link below this video, or you can head straight along to itgenius.com/transfer. If you need help from our team, jump along to our chat here and our team will be willing to assist with anything that you need. Right now, we're available primarily in Australian business hours, although we have extended hours available for European customers, and we'll soon be adding US time zones as well. So look out for those in the future. If you're not yet on our mailing list, head along to our website and download one of our ebooks. You'll get access to any future announcements that we make on the email list. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers.